I hope you can see my screen easily. So I will just start by giving the 10 minutes review process, what we did in the last, in the first session, which was held on 4th of July from 13 to 15. So in that one, first we discussed about some basic information about the Abacus. How can we use Abacus not only for our research purposes, for our design, and how can we earn money from Abacus by making our profile on the Fiverr, on the freelancer sites. So in the first section, we covered the basic geometric modeling. We model, this is the model of the beam, which we model in Abacus. First, we model the concrete beam, then we model the steel plates, and then we model the steel bars. And then we did the assembly procedure, which is here. I told you how can we define the parts from this to the assembly module. How can we define the different reference points which make our life more easy towards this thing. So these are some points which we discovered last time. So before starting over today's lecture, the first thing which I just want to request all of you, that I hope all of you successfully install the Abacus on their laptops and computers. So in the first half, what I will going to do up to the around 7, around just before the Maghrib prayer, I will cover up today's point. And then after the Maghrib prayers, I will come back and I will call randomly names. I will call randoms your names. And then you have to share your screen and you have to perform the same steps from the last session and from this session. Okay. So we define, up to now, we define the points. We already define the reinforced concrete. But what will be the bound between this concrete and the steel plate, steel bars? What will be the connections between steel plates and concrete and reaction plates or load plates? How can we go from far end from this point? So for that, first in the module section, so we done with the model. Okay, we done with the parts. Up to now, we didn't in this one, we are not going to touch materials and the calibrations. We have to first complete the last session remaining point, which is the surface and the boundary conditions. So these are the two things first we will cover. So in the features, what are the features? Features are the points which we define from the written surface. So if I clear anything, if I double click any point, that point will be highlighted on this side. You can see easily. So this point is here. So this point, these are the references. So this is the point which I defined for myself so that I can model an accurate geometry, which is very close to my experimental setup. In every software, there are a lot of assumptions. We cannot replicate the actual facts and figures what we experienced in the lab, but we try our best with the available resources, with the available mechanics. We try our best to model our FEM, to develop our FEM model as close as possible towards the reality. Now, what are the sets? What are the surfaces? I will come back to the sets later on, but for now I'm just starting with the surface. So what are the surface? Surface meaning so these I'm just height my I did just I height my beam. I can resume my beam, for example, by showing. So now I just height it because I want to work with these three surfaces. The one surface, which is the bottom surface of the load plate, this is the top where I will apply my load. I am calling that plate as a load plate, and where I am going to apply the boundary condition, the support condition, I am calling this as a support plates. We know all these three plates, they are identical, having the same geometry dimensions, and we will assign the same geometry property, but in the third module, not now, not today. So what are the surface? I told you last time that while modeling, the first model, you have to spend good time on your modeling, so that if after 10 or 5 years, if you open your model towards your students, towards your junior, you should know what the nomenclature you used during the modeling. So the nomenclature of the files, nomenclature of the surface, nodes, sets, they are very important to the modeling. In fact, I'm not going to rename these datum points, but I still remember in 2015, in the first year of my PhD, I used to rename it. For example, I rename it origin. So this is my origin. So I just shorted name origin. Then I rename it steel bar, steel plate, location of steel plate, location of sport plate, location of steel bar. But now I'm not wasting this time, because I used this node just once. But the surface I keep using the surface and the sets again. That's why I'm spending good quality of time on the surface. So how we can define the surface? So this is your 3D model. First, rotate it. So in the first one, I want to select this bottom face. Jabra clicks on the surface. Now rename it. So this is bottom surface of load plate. Okay, this is I'm not writing the whole, I'm just using the abbreviation. So the bottom surface of the load plate. Click, and just if I click here, it will become that surface. If I click here, it will become surface. It will click here. So I'm just selecting the surface of my 3D model, which I defined in the parts module. But here, as my model has 6 faces, and each 6 faces will have a different meaning for me, for my experiment. So I'm just going to define the bottom surface. So this is the bottom surface. Just done it. So now we have one in the surface. Just you double click it, so it will highlight that portion and dim, and you know, make the dim of the other surfaces. So this is done. Now what next? Now the next thing is that I want to select this surface of my support plates, because they are in contact with my beam. Where is my beam? This is my beam. Okay, so this I'm only interested with this one. So I'm just hide it. Again, surface. Now, this time, it is top surface of sport plate. As for sport, so sport plate. Or we have two faces, or we can do it with together, but I'm just doing it individually. So that will be one. Top surface of sport plate, one. So I will call this one near the origin as one. Just done it. Repeat the same step. Top surface of sport plate 2. So what I did normally, what is my habit, that when I'm doing the modeling, so you know that we save the temp file here. So these are the temp files where our model, our backers, our pre-processing, so I make a file here in Excel. Just naming symbols, I think more. And I make a list it here just for my revision. So the bottom surface of load plate, what is mean? This is that mean. Because your model will be checked by your examiner, your model will be checked by your internal supervisor, or maybe some senior associate professor, senior associate researchers. So you know that you're modeling yourself, you know each and everything. Maybe you will name it as X and Y, and you know what is X, you know Y. But the checker, it's very horrible for him, and he call you again, and he write a lot of email to you. Please explain what is this. So this is bottom surface of load plate, and so on. So you can just complete the file by your own. So this is what I used to do, and what I my supervisor asked me to do for him. So I just defined in three surfaces. Okay. Now I'm going to hide these three plates. I don't need this one. And now I going to select, you know, now, sorry. Now I'm going to show my beam. Now same thing, I'm just going to surface. So it's a top surface of beam concrete. Sorry, use capital, top surface of beam concrete. So this is my top surface, okay? This is my top surface. But there is a problem. What is the problem? If I just select it here, so it is just selected here, okay? This is selected here. But this is not the actual case. Why? Why it is not the actual case? So you can see that here, my load plate has a dimension up to from, I think 310 millimeter. But I selected the whole surface. This is not correct. It should be contact with this one. Otherwise, the abacus, the complex equation in the abacus, they will not converge with each other. So they will not converge with each other. So how can we use that thing? Okay. So first, just delete that surface. So we can just delete it here, rename, edit. So just delete it here. Done. So now top surface is deleted. Now using partition cell, we are going to divide our beam, our reinforced concrete beam, into three segments. Why? We need one segment here, one segment here, one segment here, like this. So just select this, select the object. Do we need to divide plate? No, we need to divide reinforced concrete beam. Select it. Done. Point normal, 3 points, normal to edge. We are going to use point and normal again and again. So point and normal. And how can we use that thing? Select point. Now select the point. Do we want to divide with this point? No, we want to divide from this point, from the edge. Along which plan? Along this plan? No, along this vertical, perpendicular to this plan. Just click here, create a partition. So this will become. So now if you see that 3D shape, it's cut from the whole concrete beam. And now the area of this surface and the area of this surface are same. So you can see, just by using, now if we divide anything, if we assign, if we connect that these two things, they will be very easy for us. No problem with us. Okay. Done. Again, this done. Point three. Okay. Select the object, select the point. This is the point. This is the plane. So when you select the plane, the arrow will be come on X axis, create partition. So this is the here, but we also need here. Done. Again, go here. Done. Done. Shape. Last time you asked me a question that why I use the independent mesh. So when you have a dependent mesh, when you provide your mesh in the part, because in the part we have that mesh thing. Feature, so we have that mesh thing here. Feature, so we can divide, we can assign the mesh here. So this is the reason while importing the parts in the assembly, I asked that all that are independent from their parent parts. So these are the parent parts, these are the duplicates of these parent parts. For example, right now, just for the sake of the, I'm just going to make dependent. So the first thing we'll notice, the plus sign will be goes. So the plus sign will be goes. That's mean now I have to provide here. So here will become engineering features, the mesh will be appear. But if I use this command, then by having the partition, it will not going to part. I cannot play with it. You can see that my partitions will be removed. Here my partition will be removed. So this is the reason why I don't use dependent mesh thing. I always use make it independent. And now as I just did it, all my partition, they are deleted. Now I have to repeat the previous step. So this is the answer of your question that why we are, and when we make independent, the mesh option will be disappear from the engineering features. So this is the answer of your question, Shiv, which you asked me last time. Okay. Now I'm just quickly do again and again. Just follow the steps. Shiv, do you have any question, Shiv?
No, sir. सर जी क्लियर हो गया सर।
ओके थैंक यू।
थैंक यू सर।
बच्चे हैंड रेस कर लिया करें वो, ताकि मुझे आइडिया हो कौन पूछ रहा है और फिर मस्जिद को इंगेज कर सकूँ।
सर थैंक यू।
I'm repeating the same steps again and again so that you can easily capture and adjust these steps. And when you are going to, you know, perform your own model, inshallah, we will start working on your model. We'll discuss about the assignments, about the paper. So these are the three steps. Okay. So now my concrete beam is divided into 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 small parts. They are part. They are connected with each other. Okay, now one more thing. We select, we create it, we make the partition from our defined beam. There is one more step. In our part, we just define that part. In our part, we define the middle part. Again, this part. So we define 5 parts. If we define the 5 parts in our parts module, unlike the one whole beam, then we have to provide the connections between these two parts, like what we are doing for the steel plates and the concrete. So never use, some people, they use different parts of a concrete beam and then they connect with each other. So don't make your life horrible. Just follow the simple steps. Just make it as simple as you can possible. Okay. Now I'm just going to hide my steel plates. Why? Because I want to select the respective surfaces, and now I'm going to define a surface. So now this is time top surface of BC. Okay, so this is the actual surface which is in the contact with the steel plates, not the whole top surface. Now this time it is right. Now rotate the beam so you can see the bottom. You can see the bottom surfaces. Now again, bottom surface of BC. Now remember, I named one of the origin. So one is that one, two will be this one. One, select this, done. Just I cross check it. Is the one this one? I just want to make sure that, yes, the one is this one. Now, top surface of BC 2. So these are the things which we define. So these are the surfaces. Now, what about the interactions? What about the boundary conditions? So now, before going to the further for the interaction, first, I just make a mistake. Okay, now before going towards the, you know, before going to the further step, first we have to divide the support plates, because normally, if you, I'm just going to open the same paper. So you can see that the reaction, the steel plate, center of the steel plates is connected with the rigid frame, okay? Concrete pedestal or a rigid frame, or normally now we do not have a concrete pedestal. We have a strong concrete slab of around 12 inches or 18 inches. It's a very strong concrete slab. And we bolted our beam or the bridge piers or the slab with that strong floor, and that strong floor has assessed there, so we can go under that slab and we do the bolting and the so we can provide whatever kind of the support we required for our structure. So now this is the at the middle. So what is the middle? Why I'm focusing on this thing? So before going further, I'm just again divided my this steel plates into 4 pieces. So this is one, Okay, I think 2 is enough. Okay. And similarly for this one. Now, I just want to make sure that whether the further partition will disturb my surface. No, this, so you can see that it will not disturb my surface. Otherwise, if it disturb, I have to reselect the things. So you can see my single face will become in a two phase, and my single face will become into two phases. So this is a good thing. Okay. Similarly, for the point load, I will apply the point load at the center. This is my assumptions. Obviously, in the side we do not have any point load. So we have a steel plate, but this is my assumption. Okay. So now I'm going to do. And just going to check it again. So this is the bottom surface. So you can see 4 scales. Okay, that's mean we are correct. We do not have any problems. Now these are the surfaces. But how can we use surfaces? We can use surfaces in a constrained tab. So if I just reduce the steps. So after the assembly, we have something steps. What are the steps? We'll discuss field, history, output. We'll discuss these 3 points. And then we'll go towards the constraint. Okay. So what are the constraint? Constraint means that what will be the type of the surface bounding between the load plate to the concrete, between the concrete beam to the support plate. So it will define us. So the one is, so when you open it, it will have tie, rigid, display, coupling, adjust point, embedded region. So do we need embedded region? Yes, we need embedded regions for our steel bars, which are embedded into the concrete. But right now we are working with the stainless steel plates. So that will be tie or rigid. So just click tie. So when you click on tie, you have to choose the master type. So now here I will use the note so that I can just share that what is that meaning, what are the meanings of these things. So this is the previous, previous lecture. I'm just going to make a new page here. Yes. So I'm just drawing the front face for you. This is the front face, okay, of your concrete. And we did right now. We did right now, okay? We did it up to now. We just divide the things. Now we have to assign these red lines, these red surfaces, the interaction, the bounding, how this surface, the connection, the contact will serve under the loading condition. So our load will be applied somewhere at this point, at the center point. So this, the blue arrow, is our load. So just consider this as a roller, or this as a hinge. Okay, I played. I mentioned both the supports as a roller, both supports as the hinge, and then I run the model. So this is something which you have to do by your own. Today we'll only define the origin line. So this is our origin. Origin face as a hinge and the other side as the roller. What will be the difference if I assign roller here, hinge here, both the rollers, both the hinge, because we know that right now we do not have the third equation of equilibrium. We have only these two equations of equilibrium. Sigma Fy is equal to zero, sigma M is equal to zero. There is no X, so we do not need X. We do not need axial load. So there is no applied axial load, so we do not need that equation. So only two equations will be governing in this case. So you will play by yourself. Okay, now, in that thing, what I learned from different review, from different literature, even from YouTube videos, that the load is coming from this plate, so this is the master. So this is the master for that thing, and this is the slave, the red one is the slave for this surface. But when the load comes to the concrete, now the concrete is applying load on this steel plate. So now that will be become master, sorry. Now that will become master, and that will become master, and this will become slave. So if I just write what in my start of my FEM career, what I did, I used to make a table for me so that I don't make any blunder in the modeling. So what I did, I will use master face, I will write on a page, and slave. So for the master, bottom steel plate, load plate LP, for slave beam. So these will be connected with each other. Similarly, beam with the support plate. Okay. Now, how can we assign this strain in a backup? They're very easy. Go to strain. Select tie. Now, load plate. Now, select the master. Choose the master type. Surface or region? Surface. Now, in surface, I can choose this one, I can choose this one, or I can just hide my beam, select the bottom. But I do not know, I don't need this thing. Why? Because I already defined the surfaces. I have six surfaces. So how can I select this thing? Don't select anything from here, just went to the surface. Now, these are the surfaces which we defined just 20 minutes before. So what will be the, in the load plate, who will be the master? The bottom of the steel plate? Bottom of the load plate. Do you want to highlight it? Highlight it. So that will be the highlight. Okay. So this sign, that force scale will belong to that load plate. Continues. Now, choose the slave type. Surface. Sorry, I just write a wrong space spelling of the. Sorry. Now, what will be the slave on this side? Top of beam. Top of beam. This one. Can you highlight it? Tie. I'm just repeating it. Load plate. Tie. Surface. Master. What will be the master's? Bottom of the load plate. Bottom of the load plate. Continues. Surface. What will be the slave? Top surface of the concrete beam. Continues. So here it will master and the slave. We can, if we correct wrong, we can just click it here. It will just repeat it like this. Or like this. So these are correct. Bottom face, surface of the load plate will be the master. Top surface of the beam concrete will be the slave. Done. So this is the one thing. Similarly, we have to provide the interaction here, interaction here. So I'm going to use quickly. Port 1, tie, yes. Master, what will be the masters? Master will be the bottom surface of the beam concrete. Continues. Slave, top of the support concrete. Continues. Done. I think we make a mistake. I will just cross check it with you. Support 2, tie. Master, BC2, continues, slave, so that will be the slave, continues, done. I'm confusing here, just cross check me. So TCB should be appear without plus nishan. TSBC, okay. Load plate. TSBC, okay. If you have any error, we will come back. After submitting the job, if we have any corrections, we will come back to this point and we'll cross check it again. So that's how, by having the good nomenclature on the surfaces, that part will become easy. Otherwise, I saw some on some YouTube or some people, they are using to hide the beam, to hide the steel plate, and they will confuse. I make a mistakes here. So these are the interactions between the supports. Now, how can we use sets? In the sets, first I will define a nomenclature point load geometry. Now here again, the surface will be type of geometry or meshing. I am working on the unmesh object. So geometry. So that will be the point of my load plate where I'm going to apply the load in form of our displacement. So we will learn about our displacement based analysis. What are the difference between the displacement based analysis, load based analysis? We'll discuss in the analysis section. Okay. So just here. So I just defined a point here. One more thing. This is port 1, click, port 2, this is port 2, okay? So now, up to now, we cover the interactions, we define the sets. Now I'm just going jump to the boundary condition. So BC, boundary condition, I'm just leaving the load, the analysis, everything like that. But before the boundary condition, I need to define the steps. Now, what are the steps? How will be it run? So up to now, just assume that I constructed my beam in the lab. I did the curing for 14 days or 24 days, and then I just, with the help of the crane, I just shift my beam on my testing ring, and now I'm going to apply the analysis. So up to now, the geometry, the okay, we forget the rebars. So just come back to the rebars, and then we will come back to the analysis point. So now, how we can define the rebars? For the rebars, just hide your beam. So I'm going to hide my beam and constrain. So now rebars, name it rebars, embedded region, continues. Select the embedded region. So these are the embedded region. Okay, we didn't make a set here. So just go back, just delete it here. Just go to the set. Rebars, geometry, and these are the rebars, okay? Done. Now, come back to strain. Region, don't use set here, just go here, sets, rebars, highlight it, done. Select the method of host region. select the region or just use whole model. I just use whole model because it will also check whether my embedded region are in the whole model or is the my embedded region, my rebirth, they are outside from the whole model. So just select whole model. So this is the weight factor, runoff, and the friction, the fractional, stereo, tolerance, the absolute tolerance, absolute, fractional. So just select OK. What are these meaning? When we'll discuss, when we are doing the analysis, we'll discuss that thing in detail again. So, but right now the embeddedness are rebirth and the host is complete. So this is, and you said whenever you apply the constraint, the dots, the circulars, they are appear. They are not our reference point. Don't confuse with the reference point. These tell us that now they are in a constraint. They are in a sub tie or in some embedded regions. Now, before going to define the boundary condition, let's define the step. Just double click on the steps. And here you will see the global application of the S. The procedure type, journal, linear, I will use journal, coupled, thermal, direct cyclic, dynamic, implicit, dynamic, asymptotic, geostatic, heat, mass diffusion, soil, statics, visco. So I'm just using static journal right now because this is the purpose of my module one. Just continue, see. Now, these are where these things are very important, especially about the description. You can write out just a 3-point load. Find bending test on RCC beam. Why is 3-point? Because we have a 1 load point and 2 support points. Automatic stabilizer. Up to now, I'm not using anything specific, dissipation energy, specific dumping factor, use dumping factor. I'm not going to in detail of these things. We will discuss that thing when we have a trouble in the analysis. Right now, just like none. The increment. So these are, if I just take a fixed, so this is the maximum number of the increment. So that's mean my load, my displacement of my which I'm going to apply as a load on my beam will be applied in 100 steps, and each step has a unit of 1. So if this is 1000, and the how much the increment, so now it will become the maximum number of increments 1000, and now my step of 10 millimeter, for example, 10 millimeter into divided by 0.1. So assume that I have 10 millimeter load, okay, 10 divided by 0.1. So that will be the, so these are the total steps. So I will cover 10 millimeter in 100 steps. Now, what are the steps? How can they impact our load? Remember, when you perform a compressive strength in your lab on a cylinder or a cube, your supervisor, your instructor told you about that the rate of loading is this. So we have to, our rate of the loading should be respect to the standard against the different type of the loading. So if we are going to perform a compressive test, the rate of loading different. From the tensile, the rate of the loading different. From the split cylinder test, for the column. So the step, because if you apply, it's a normal observation in the daily routine life, if you apply a heavy load instantly without any time, your member may be carry more load or maybe collapse at one. But if you apply the heavy load in the increment sequence, then maybe your member will take more load. So the rate of loading is very important. And also that there's a research going on that how the rate of the loading will affect the maximum size of the aggregate, because that's the aggregate in the concrete. Before showing the crushing of the concrete, which are taking a lot of load. After the crushing, after the cracking of the concrete, then the steel will become the vulnerable member, which will take maximum load. So these are the things. What is my practice? I use the automatic. I didn't use the fixed. And I asked that the increment starting with the point one, also with the meshing point one, and the minimum increment load is this. If we are defining the initial, if we are defining the maximum increment, the maximum increase in load respect to the previous load, then why we need the minimum? Because this is depends upon the conversion, upon the algorithms which is using the which is used by the backers to solve the problem. So this is, that's why. So just take it, just make it 10 or automatic. So now whatever you make here, it will be become irrelevant. So now it will use the maximum number of increment 10,000.1 like this. What are the others? Others are also very important. Equation solver, direct, yes, always use direct. Direct and iterative have their own merits and demerits. The practice is to use in the static is direct. Metric storage, unsymmetric, symmetric, use solver default. If you use unsymmetric, symmetric, then these things appear. So for the symmetric, say that the analysis code may override your metric storage choice. So use default. Solution technique, either it will be Newton, full Newton, or quasic Newton. So the full Newton, if I select the quasic Newton, it will ask me the number of alteration of a kernel matrix. So what are the kernel matrix, quasic Newton? We are not going to detail in this thing. Just use the full Newton when, because I am using the problem when we in the sixth and seventh session we will have a difficult form of analysis of our conversion problem, and then we'll come back to these things. Or in the second module when we are dealing with the cyclic loading, then we will discuss this thing in detail. So the convert seven discrete alteration server discrete alterations. So this is propagate from the previous step. This is also very important. So whatever you have the result from the previous step, use from that results. Do the calculation from this result. And then the long-term solution, time-dependent material. So for example, if you are working against the creep and the fatigue, you will use this thing. But right now we are working with the static test, and that will be finished within a half an hour or 1 hour. So just use this one. Linear, yes, our increment should be linear, not be a parabola, and just done it. So now we define the static analysis. Now, after defining the static analysis, now I'm going to define the boundary conditions. Boundary conditions. Here you can see my step. Initial, static. So it's static. What are the initial meanings? Initial meaning everything before you put the specimen on the testing rig. So you provide, you apply the load, you apply the steel plate, you move the beam, you do the rebar embedment in the concrete. So these things you did it. But now you're going to define the analysis, and the supports will be contributed from the static analysis. So now it will have the symmetric. So first I will just use the mechanical, electrical, magnetic. We are dealing with the mechanical, symmetric. So if you use the symmetric, it will ask me to select the load. So I will just select the geometric one, which is just highlight here. So I don't need to select it here because I defined everything. Whatever I want from my geometry, I already labeled all the parts, all the geometry members, and now just to select the things and highlight it, continues. So now if it will ask me that U1, 1 mean X, 2 mean Y, 3 mean Z. Remember this point. Now, if I select this thing, what will be that meaning? There is the object will not move in horizontal direction, not allow rotation in Y and Z. So this is the roller. What I decided that I will assign the one as the hinge. So where is the hinge? Hinge mean vertical strain, horizontal strain, and the movement strain. So this is the thing, U1, U2 and UR3. U mean deformation, R rotation along 3. So that will be become hinge on my this point. And we will also see the behavior. We will change the loading support condition, and during our session, we will see how will it affect our analysis. So just click it down. Again, this continues sport to this time. I just want to restrain the vertical movement, not the horizontal, vertical movement. You too. Done. So these are the things. So if I show you by having the physical symbols, they are same. But we know that these are these different things. Okay. So these are the things which we have to cover in the last session, but we couldn't. Now, before taking the Maghrib prayer break from at 7:15, I'm just to do the meshing. Okay, one more thing. Last time I told you that the concept of the meshing, the different shape of the meshing will be described by Dr. Muhammad Iqbal, but unfortunately he will not available today, but he promised me he will be available on the Saturday. So what I'm going to do, because we have a lot of audience from the bachelor level, so now I'm going to use the meshing modeling here, and you will note your questions from the meshing. I will try my best to answer them, but Dr. Muhammad Iqbal is the right person for this job. Okay, now how can I do the meshing? Just go, we define the part, just ignore property, we define the assembly, we define the load, we define the interactions. So these are the interactions, the constraint, create the constraint. We define load. Okay, let define the load, and then we'll come back to the mesh. Now, load. I told you that I'm going to apply, I will apply the displacement-based analysis. I will run the displacement-based analysis. What does that mean? That's meaning in the data logger, if I hope that the master students or the senior faculty member, they have a good experience that we have when we are going to perform the experiment, we have a data logger, we have the monitor, we have different LVDTs attached at different points of the of our structure, either lateral, either vertical, either circular, and we have the notation. So always, it is always a good practice to apply the load by displacement control. Why? Whenever there's a big experiment, the people, the smart people, they find out the analytical value of the load carrying capacity of that beam by using the codes, by using the physical models, or maybe by modeling in the Abaqus or Adena. So they know the maximum load carrying capacity, maybe 20 ton, let's suppose. And they also find out the deflected shape. So the deflection is always safe. Why I'm using the safe word? Because our apparatus, LVDTs, strain gauges, the wires, the whole experimental rig is very costly. During the experiment, we have that aim that whatever, there should be a minimum damages to our experiment rig. So if we use the load analysis, we can see both the load and the displacement, but that will be controlling by the load. Okay, so we keep applying, and who knows that maybe the analytical model tell us that we have 20 kips 20 newton load carrying capacity, but that will become, or 20 kips load carrying capacity, but it will become 15 kips, and after 15 kips there will be some damages. So to reduce that damages, it's a very good and safe practice to use to apply that displacement base analysis. That's what I got the answer from my supervisor when I asked him that why we use the displacement control analysis. If the senior, if the faculty member have the better justification that why people use load carrying, people use displacement analysis rather than the load analysis. So I will take the suggestion at the end. So now we are modeling which beam? We are modeling this beam. OA1, okay, and the mid span is here, okay, and the mid span tell us that the one bar is 0.1 inches. So here is 0.1 inches, 0.2 inches, and maybe 0.3 inches. Okay. So this is the scale. So convert 0.3 into 25.4 millimeter. So we'll get 7.68 millimeter around. So that curve goes up to 7.6 millimeter. So in your own problems or the paper which I just give you the assignment, you have to just read the load deflection curve. Deflection at the midpoint, we are applying the load at the midpoint. So the maximum deflection will be 6. So we are going to apply 8, just apply above. So we have a good failure. Now use the load, point load or displacement point load. Now we have different options: mechanical, electrical, magnetic. Obviously it is a mechanical. Concentrated force, movement, pressure, shell, gravity, line load. So it's a concentrated force point. Yes, 2 mean y, minus mean downward. So I'm going to apply 0.8, minus 8. What are the minus 8? Sorry, we have to define, if we have run to the displacement, so we have to define the displacement in the boundary condition. Because in load, if I selected the point load, and my point, the load point here, so it will become CF. CF always mean concentrated force. So I'm not defining the concentrated force. If I have to define the concentrated force, then what will be the value of that concentrated force? That will be around 70 kips, but not 70 kips, the equivalent of the 70 kips in newtons. But I'm not going to define the force in the newtons, okay? So I will not use CF thing. I will just come back to my boundary condition, which is again the loading, load, displacement load, DISP, load. In this one, now I will use select the displacement, continuous point load, highlight the point load. This is the point load, continues, and here the U2. So what will be the U2? Minus 8. So here you can see name displacement, type displacement, step static analysis, region point load, uniform distribution. Yes, uniform distribution. Ramp. So these are the amplitude. So for the cyclic, we will work on the ramp. I will show you how we can define the cyclic. The similar problem on which the shape is working on the cyclic testing. So I will apply. I will know you at that time. We will discuss how to apply the amplitude. So U2 meaning displacement. Otherwise, if it is CF2, that means we have to provide the 80 kips, equivalent of 80 kips in Newton. So minus 8. Just define minus 8. So you can see this is your load. Okay. Now save your model. Now after the load, we will come back to the mesh. Now how can we define the mesh? And what are the general property of the mesh? So just click here mesh. And as you know, our all parts, they are independent. So whatever we defined here, that will be their meshing property. Now, the first thing is this one. Assign element type. Most of the mesh error are associated with this thing, assign element type. So just like assign, or just just assign, select this or part, done. Now remember, when we're defining the steel plate, it was 3D stress. Concrete, 3D stress. Steel bar, 3D stress. So what we are going to do, just cancel it. Go to the steel plate, steel bars, hide them so we cannot select them. Now the steel bars are not appearing here. Now select assign type and select the whole model, because all these members, they are 3D defined. They are 3D defined. Done. And now the family of the machine will goes to the 3D stress. If you have a steel bar, the family will be changed. How will be changed? I will just show you in the next step. Now this is a 3D stress. So this is the one thing. If you define a solid member as a 3D, as a solid in your part while defining the part, so the family of the mesh should be 3D. If your part is belongs to the wire, the family of, then the family will be the truss. Okay, in the next step I will show how we'll assign the truss. Now these are the critical meanings of the these are the critical parameters which we have to discuss for the meshing. The first one, standard. Yes, we are using to a standard library, or we can also use the explicit, but right now standards. In the standards, the next thing is the geometric order. So just assume standard, linear, and uncheck hybrid, uncheck reduction, uncheck incompatibility. So when you use standard and linear, C3D8, a 8-knot linear brick will be appear. That means when whatever the size we assign to the mesh, we have a cube, and we know that the cube has 8 nodes. Yes, the cube has 8 nodes. Just take a mobile in your hand. And you can write, you can count the 8 nodes, 4 top nodes, 4 bottom nodes. So this is the cube, similar to the cube. Now, what happens if I just select the hybrid? See, C3D8H will appear. What happens if I select the hybrid and the reduction? It will be appear. Simple, meaning hybrid, constant pressure, reduction, integration. Incompatibility. So 3C3D8IH. So all these things will be appeared. So I cannot use reduction and incompatible together, but I can use hybrid reduction, hybrid incompatible. So this is the one thing. But I'm working on the hexa. Hexa mean cube. Now just make a complex thing. Just change it here. And in the linear, go to the wedge point. So the wedge meaning C3DC. Now the mesh, the square block is not more cube. Now it's a wedge, 3D wedge. And the 3D wedge has 6 nodes. Hybrid? Yes, hybrid. Now go to the tetra. So the tetra means, just you remember, in the 90s and 2000, we have a tetra pack milk, and that tetra is a 3D triangular, and it has a 4 nodes, the one at the top and the 3 at the bottom triangulars. So that tetra will become from this side. Hybrid, that's meaning the hybrid. So these are the meanings. So right now in the linear, the maximum is the hexa. But if I change from the linear to the quadratic, now in the hexa, I have a cube brick having the maximum nodes of 28. Again, hybrid or reduction. Of quadratic wedge, 15. Quadratic tetra, 10. Okay? So these are the things. So these are the things in the standard format. But what about if I just change my library from the standard to the explicit? So now we see explicit linear, D, 6, the nodes will be same, but now we have different parameters. Second order accuracy, disorientation control, conversion, element. So these things will be appear, which will be not appearing in the standard. In the standard, what we have? Viscosity, which is a very critical, user defined. Viscosity, what is the viscosity? Viscosity, we'll discuss in detail when when we are defining the concrete property, remember me, at that time we'll come back to this again. Kinematic split, second order accuracy, distortion, and the different parameters. So the normal practice is to use standard linear, but you should know this thing. And this is the calibration procedure. So right now, 3D, standard linear, 3D done. And we just selected done. Up to now, we didn't define the mesh. We just defined the mesh family. Now we are going to define the mesh. Select this point, the dotted point, seed part. Select your whole object. Then select 50 millimeter, assume just 50 millimeters. Apply. It's very fine mesh. Okay, 50 is enough. Okay, I think 50, that will be okay. And then again, select the seed part, mesh part, done. So this is, you can see how fine they are, how fine they are connected with each other. Is the mesh, they are connected with other, the steel mesh, the concrete mesh, and they are all connected. It's a uniform pattern. So if I just remove my cursor, you cannot distinguish between the steel plate and the concrete bar or the member. So this is the beauty of the meshing. Done. Now just hold on. I just want to share more thing with you. Okay, let me complete with the steel bar, and then I will show you how you can play more. Now hide all the 3D members, so the 3D member hide, and show the steel bars. So these are, and you see that they are not still, up to now they are not assigned any mesh. Now go mesh, select assign type, select the object. Select the object, go to the mesh. Now the family will become changed. Now the 3D is not coming here. We have either beam for the wire member or the truss. Right now we will use truss. If we are dealing with a problem of the bound slip problem, I hope you know what is the bound slip problem between the concrete and the steel, then we'll use the beam. And then we will not define steel bar as a wire, we'll define steel bar as a 3D. So that's another problem. So standard, linear, two note. So each steel bar will be divided in a one piece, and each piece has a two notes. Protected, three notes. Make it linear. Done. Now select the same 50. Done. So the green meaning that now you define it. Now the steel bars and that everything is meshed. We define the mesh to all our members. And you can see the meshing is here. All the color are ready with the green. So now we are just stopping my problem here. So remember, what is the general mistake? First, you have to select the object, assign the family, then assign the seat size, then assign the mesh. On such a day, inshallah, Dr. Iqbal will discuss what will be the meshing nodes, how will it affect our analysis, what will be the different type of the meshing, how can we use the optimized mesh size. And believe me, defining the mesh in FEM is still ongoing research. It's still active research. Want to show you how we have to define the mesh thing. So these are the mesh analysis. So we call this mesh calibration. So this is the problem of one of my student work. So we used to check different mesh size, 20, 25, 30, 40, 50, 60. In that case, we only play with the mesh size. We didn't play with the mesh type either. So here we can, you can see that the standard calibration is the R20 hexagonal, linear quadratic hexagonal, or triangular, or tetrahedral H with the hybrid, or steel bars, or beam and concrete. So you have to define the nomenclature. You can see this paper, you can read this paper, cite this paper, and these are the mesh types. So we did the meshing on the size. We use different mesh size, and you can see the response is different. The dotted line is the blue dotted line are from the experiment. If I just enlarge the screen with you, so the blue part is from the experiment and the other rest are. So you can see that if the mesh is higher, 40, 50, 60, the bars are away from the experimental line. But if the mesh is 20, 25, 30, so using the fine mesh, reasonable fine mesh, that will be, we can also use 10 millimeter or 5 millimeter, but that will increase our problem, analysis problem. Okay. So this up to now, we defined the section, we defined the set, we defined the meshing, the common mistakes. So I try to cover the mesh concept here. Now, if you have any questions, just raise your hand. And I will try my best to answer your question. And then we'll take a 10 minutes prayer break. And then we'll come back. And then I will ask all of you to open your abacus and start a problem from your assignment. If anyone perform it, because I uploaded the assignments from the yesterday, if any one of you complete the assignments up to the previous module, not about the meshing, he will share their experience with us. So now first I will take your answers. If you have any, first I will take your questions. So if you have any questions, please ask. Yes, roll number 63.
अस्सलाम वालेकुम सर. सर क्वेश्चन मेरा ये था कि हमें जो असाइनमेंट मिली है उसमें एक कॉलम है, कॉलम में जो आर्म स्ट्रिप्स लगे हुए हैं जो क्लोज्ड टाइज हैं, एक तो वो हम रेक्टेंगुलर ज्योमेट्री से मॉडल कर लेंगे, लेकिन उसमें सर हुक्स भी लगे हुए हैं जिसमें एक साइड पे 90 डिग्री का बैंड है, दूसरी साइड पे 135 डिग्री का बैंड है, जो हुक्स टाइज होते हैं सर, उसको हम कैसे मॉडल करेंगे बैकस में?
ठीक है, ये हुक्स वाला मुझे पता है, मुझे प्रॉब्लम आना था इसको हुक्स वाले को ना. मैं इंशाल्लाह आज आपके आपसे पहले प्रैक्टिस करवा लूँगा मैं ट्रेनिंग के ऊपर, उसके बाद जो है ना मैं हुक्स वाले का जवाब आपको दूंगा कि उसको हम कैसे मॉडल करते हैं. इट्स वेरी इजी, बिलीव मी, बाय यूजिंग द लाइन कमांड जो हमने लास्ट टाइम किया था, हम कोऑर्डिनेट्स देते रहेंगे, हुक्स अपने आप बनता रहेगा. इट वेरी वेरी इजी. आई विल शो यू, डोंट वरी अबाउट इट. अभी असाइनमेंट के लिए आप विदाउट हुक भी जा सकते हैं, लेकिन आज मैं हुक्स और लैप्स को जो है ना बताऊँगा, डिफाइन करूँगा. जी, एनी अदर क्वेश्चंस अबाउट टुडेज मशीन प्रॉब्लम, द मशीन टाइप्स? इरफान, डू यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चन? इरफान खान, इरफान बच्चे आप हैं हमारे साथ?
सर
बच्चे आवाज बहुत ऐसा आ रही, थोड़ा ऊंचा बोलें.
सर No problem, sir.
कोई प्रॉब्लम है, कोई इशू है? इजीली आप समझ रहे हैं चीजों को जो मैं समझाना चाह रहा हूँ? थैंक यू. कश्माला बच्चे आप हैं हमारे साथ?
जी सर, यहीं पर हूँ.
बच्चे कोई प्रॉब्लम, आपका कोई इशू?
नहीं सर, अभी तक तो कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, कुछ हुआ तो आई डिस्कस.
ओके, आदिल इम्तियाज
सर.
जी बच्चे, आपको कोई प्रॉब्लम सर, कोई इशू?
नहीं सर, अभी तक तो सर कोई इशू नहीं आया, क्लियरली अंडरस्टूड व्हाट यू टॉक.
देखिए मैं चीजें डिटेल में, मुझे पता है जैसे माशाल्लाह शुएब है मेरा अपना स्टूडेंट, तनवीर जो है वो इन मॉडलिंग फेज से, इस एनालिसिस फेज से निकल चुके हैं, लेकिन मैंने बिगनर्स को अपने साथ लेके चलना था तो थोड़ा टाइम ज़्यादा मुझसे लग जाता है डिस्कशन करते हुए बताते हुए. तो आप लोग मुझसे पूछ सकते हैं, मुझे कह सकते हैं कि सर आप थोड़ा स्पीड तेज़ अप करें या स्लो कर लें, वाइस वर्सा, आप मुझे अपने फीडबैक दे सकते हैं टाइमली. ओके
सर. ओके सर, थैंक यू.
फहद, फहद एनी क्वेश्चन बच्चे? फहद, फहद अब्दुल्ला. तारिक महमूद, तारिक
सर मुझे जो है वो कुछ जो सिविल से रिलेटेड आप